What's going on, guys? Christian here from CK Wraps. Today, I'm gonna show you how to wrap this Alfa Romeo Stelvio mirror cap in Avery Gloss Obsidian Black using the tool that I have in my hand right now. This tool is gonna make things a lot easier. I've had this tool for a while now, I just haven't done a video on it, but it's gonna make things a lot easier. I figured, hey, why not just do this video for demonstration purposes to show you guys what you can use to potentially make your mirror wraps a lot easier and maybe more durable down the road. Now, I'm not leaving the gloss black on the actual mirror itself because it's real carbon fiber, but again, this video is just for learning purposes for you guys. Now, this car is getting a full, it's only a few months old, it's got a full PPF on it, and it's getting a full hexa satin titanium chrome wrap on it, as well as the door jams. The door jams are wrapped in Avery Obsidian Black, the frames themselves and the actual door panels themselves. Videos for this car will eventually be on my website, guys, ckwraps.com. I'll put a link in the top corner and in the description below for you. I've got the 4K camera on my head. I do a lot of my filming with the 4K camera to give you guys that great point of view while I'm doing cutting, trimming, stretching, corners, all that stuff. You can see in 4K now in all my updated videos that are going up on the website. Now, we're gonna get into this. This tool right here is actually called Wrap You Easy. It's by Signmakertools. I'm gonna put a link to their website and the product itself in the description below. This way you guys can grab one if you want it. It's a genius little tool, a simple invention, nothing extraordinary, but it does the job really well. Now, on this area here, it has some plastic panels, and this is gonna allow your vinyl to adhere to it. Otherwise, it wouldn't stick very well. What you do is you take a clean table, make sure your table is very clean. You're going to put the Wrap You Easy down on the table with the plastic side facing up, and you're going to lay down your film over top of that. We're going to squeegee that out so it's nice and smooth. This way you can actually have, you know, so that sticks to it, and we're able to pull on the actual panel itself on the Wrap You Easy when we're going to be stretching the film across the mirror. It's very important that the film adheres to this panel entirely, because you want it to stick very well. We're going to be pulling on it pretty hard. Okay, guys, now that the Wrap You Easy is set up, I have it in my hands here, we're pretty much ready to rock. I've got the 4K POV camera rolling right now, and we're going to take our heat gun over to the mirror cap with the Wrap You Easy and the vinyl attached to it, and we're going to give it a good stretch all the way across. So what we need to do first here is we need to heat up the film really well, okay? You want it to be as soft and as pliable as possible. Once you see it fluttering like this, it's usually a good sign that your vinyl is hot, okay? I'm just gonna keep heating and talking here for a second, guys. It's already up to its temperature. I don't need to keep heating it, but I'm just gonna keep it warm. Now, what happens usually with mirrors is that people end up heating, then stretching and getting a part done, and then they heat and stretch again and they get another part done, and they heat and stretch again and get another part done. The problem with that is that you're gonna get discoloration lines in your mirror. Because when you heat and you stretch and you stop and then you start again, what happens is you end up either compounding stretch upon stretch, or you just end up stretching this area more than this area, and then this area gets, and then this area over here gets stretched even more than that area over there, and it's just like, it discolors the film with most brands. That's not even just like one particular brand, that's with most brands. Now, this tool right here is gonna allow the film to stretch very evenly, and I just don't want those touching the back side there. It's gonna allow the film to stretch very evenly and consistently all the way around the mirror without starting and stopping too many times. You should be able to get this done mostly in one shot. The goal here is to start and hook it in right about there. So that's where I'm gonna be hooking it in. And I'm gonna pull it across. I'm gonna stand over here actually. Get that nice and hot. You can see it's nice and fluttery. Okay, perfect. And then we're gonna take this, put the heat gun down, and we're gonna pull it across. Just like so. Pulling across is essential. It's what you have to do, okay? If you don't pull the film across, what's gonna happen is you're gonna end up pulling it to an edge too much, and the vinyl's gonna wanna pull back off of the edge. If we did this properly, the vinyl is not gonna wanna pull back off of the edges. It's gonna wanna roll around the edges. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna be very careful. We're gonna cut out our Wrap You Easy here. I just cut it around like this. I've seen other people do it different ways, but I just run it along the wood side. Makes it a little bit easier. Cool. This is now done its job. I'm just gonna put this down right here. I'm not quite to the very end of the mirror, so I can just finish that off right there. Very easy, okay? Now, I'm gonna smooth some of this out, and look at this. Look at this contour that I somehow made around this bend, almost getting this mirror done in one piece. Technically, you'd ideally wanna put a seam or a piece on the inside here. Now, I don't know if my piece is big enough to actually get this done in one piece, maybe it is. But this is a very challenging mirror because of that. And here's the line for the PPF. You're gonna see it right there. This is the PPF line. Now we can actually take this vinyl and we should be able to bring it down most of the way. I'm gonna miss the bottom corner slightly, that's okay. If I had a bit of a bigger piece, I could have gotten this done in one shot. Again, I'm not leaving it. This is just more for learning purposes and showing you guys the tool and how it works. Okay, see all these wrinkles, how they're all running across? These are very important that they all run that way. Let's grab the heat gun and heat all of this and see what happens, okay? So what should happen here is the vinyl should pull itself across and shrink around. Look at that, all tight, okay? Then if you see that, this means you know that you did it right. Look at that, it's all tight. Very important. The hardest part of this mirror would be actually nailing this bottom corner over here and getting it all to wrap around under there. So doing this in two pieces is probably definitely more ideal, simply because we're not gonna be able to get the film to be tightened up right around this corner here. You can see I have too much excess material here, it's bunching up. See, it's not shrinking down tight. But the rest of this is shrinking down and tight all the way around, which is perfect, okay? I was kind of skeptical about this tool in the beginning because I thought maybe we would have to be stretching to the edge too much, but look at that, it's all super tight, it's beautiful. It's exactly how it needs to be. I was worried that people would use it and then stretch to the edges too much, or that would cause you to stretch to the edge. Stretching to the edge is obviously a big no-no, as I said many times. This way, if you stretch to the edge, your vinyl is gonna basically wrinkle backwards off of the edge. It's gonna cause basically what we call fingering or fingers. And all we have to do now is just get this all kind of tucked in a little bit to the edges. We'll give it one more shot of heat just to make sure there's no wrinkles. There it is, all nice and tight, it's beautiful. Not the nicest finish in Avery, it's okay. There's a lot of, you can see the actual like adhesive dots, see them? Not the adhesive dots, the micro beads that they use for the pressure sensitive part of this film. You can see all those little dots there. That happens sometimes with their film. It's usually from the surface being warm or the film being warm, and then it ends up leaving little dots. People ask about that often. So doing it and getting it done cleaner than that is possible. I'm not gonna be able to go the whole way, like I said, because we have too much bunching up of the material here. But again, all I wanna do here is I'm gonna cut, and I'm gonna show you that the vinyl is not pulling off any of these edges. Let's do it. Make sure we're in that gap. It's a very tight gap here. There we go. I'm not even tucking it in, see? Let's just check it out over here. Make sure we've got the coverage we need around that little light. And again, I'm just cutting it off pretty much at the edge, guys. So if this vinyl is gonna fail, if there's tension at all on any of these edges, the vinyl will fail. It will pull back when I add heat. One of the tricks is to add heat before you cut. This way you can check and test to make sure that there is no pullback when you're right before you're ready to cut. Really tight here, guys. There we go. I think I'm cutting most of that off. Let's finish up the end. Again, here's the PPF line. You can see it. So it does leave sometimes a little bit of air in there. It depends on the film that you're using when you're wrapping over the PPF. With the hexis chrome, it's extremely difficult because the hexis chrome is so thick, especially the satin, that it makes it almost impossible to get all the air out between the PPF and the actual chrome itself. Avery's a little bit thinner, so it makes it more possible to get all that air out. Coming on down here. Really take your time. Boom. And we'll just kind of, we'll kind of call it up to this edge right here. Let's squeegee that arrow where the PPF is again. Good. And then we'll go over it with a quick little pass, because it's always important to go over with a squeegee afterwards. And then we can add a little bit of heat and just see if this vinyl is going to pull up at all or not. Let's check it out. Again, on the inside, this does need that extra piece on the inside, mainly to make the bottom taper right here. Okay, I see nothing pulling back. This is important. It's important that we're checking this right now. We did check it before we cut, but we're doing it again right now. The vinyl is cut off at the edge and I stretched it all the way across the mirror. Using this tool is, it's important to know how to actually use it, because if you, again, if you're pulling like this way up to this edge, it's gonna, the vinyl's gonna wanna pull back this way. Plus you're gonna leave yourself with a lot of slack on the bottom. If you pull more down this way to this bottom edge, you're gonna have vinyl wanting to pull off of this edge this way, and then you're gonna have too much slack on top. Pulling the film, and I kind of hooked it in the corner here, and pulling it across this way creates horizontal wrinkles that would, technically horizontal wrinkles if you get any wrinkles, they run across. All the tension is running across this way and all across this way, up to this very peak right here. As long as we pulled properly and didn't stretch too far past this very far, this corner over here, we're not gonna have any pullback off of this corner over here. It's very easy to counteract that, because again, all the tension is pulling across these edges, which makes it so that if we get the vinyl around the edge just slightly, it wants to pull itself around that edge. That's what it's doing. We're tricking the vinyl to thinking that. All right, guys, that's how we use the Wrap You Easy. Very simple, effective tool. I had a friend here actually last week, and he actually saw this, and I showed him how to use it, and he went and bought one. Hey, whatever. You know, if you think that you need this, it is a handy tool to have. It's not overly expensive either, but it does do a great job. It's very durable. It's very strong. This is, you know, that's like nine layers or something, or 10 layers of plywood here. It's very strong. It's not going to break. And this is just more or less what the plastic area looks like. Again, you saw it in the video when I was setting it up, but that's pretty much it. I've had this for about a year, maybe longer now. And again, I don't use it all the time, but sometimes I do, just if I want to speed things up and go a little bit faster. I set this up and we go and wrap the mirror, boom, bang, one time, one shot, and get it all done. Guys, I hope that this video was informative and helpful. Again, link to my website in the top corner and in the description below for you. Again, thank you for watching. I appreciate it very much. Take care.